Your voice, your opinion, your community. Fact TV, free speech protected.
Where is Sidney Prescott?
Who are the best cameos ever?
And do you think Courtney Cox ever said "do me, do me" to her husband David Arquette?
All this and more on Gory Storytime.
Warning. Gory Storytime is a horror movie review show by a son and his dad who thought that letting his five-year-old watch scary movies was acceptable. If you are offended by horror or talk about blood and gore by a child, or if you don't want horror movies from the 60s through today spoiled, then there is a remote stuck in your couch cushion next to potato chip crumbs. Use it. And of course, parental discretion is advised.
Why? You didn't use any.
Shut up and start the show.
Welcome to the special edition wide shot version of Gory Storytime. I'm your host, Jason.
I'm his co-host and father, Craig. And quickly to answer the questions, on the set of Party of Five, Jay and Silent Bob, and I would like to think so.
Yeah, actually.
Anyway.
All right, so this is the show where we review horror movies. This is the third?
Yep.
This is the fourth. This is the fourth of and four final third trilogy. Movies.
It's the fourth third movie.
This is the fourth third and movie we're doing this series of four thirds.
Yes. Sure.
This week we're doing Scream 3.
Yes.
The one where Cotton is not the killer.
that would be all of them. They had to come up with another excuse for someone to be murdering people. In a, you know,
Ghostface killer.
Wu-Tang.
Oh.
Wu-Tang reference, come on.
All right, yeah.
No. Here's the basic premise. Someone knows something about the past of Sidney Prescott, played by Neve Campbell, and is upset and wants to murder for revenge.
No, Dad, we're doing the third one.
Nope, this is the third one. This is all of the ones.
Yeah, actually.
The first one was because of her something in her family history. The second one was something in her family history. And this one is just to be different.
Is something in her family history.
Yes. We'll get into what the original idea was going to be, but that's...
And if she makes it out, I wonder what the fourth one's going to be.
But since there's not really much to say without spoilers... Other than what I just said as the description, why don't we show people that trailer?
Hello. Do you like scary movies?
Number one, the body count is always bigger. Number two, the death scenes are always much more elaborate.
What do you know about trilogies?
All I know about movie trilogies is that in the third one, all bets are off.
Hello, Sydney. Welcome to the final act.
Don't panic.
That is got to be the best trailer.
That was a good trailer. I mean, it's like, hey, remember the stuff you liked in the first two? We're doing similar stuff without repeating exactly the stuff.
Like, that was a great trailer.
Yeah, it was. Now, before we get into the behind-the-scenes information, of course, why do we really come here once a week? To make fat stacks of cash.
Yes.
Because I don't know about you, I enjoy making it rain on the ladies. Anyway, and how do we do that? By selling our souls to
yes.
For cash.
Not the ads we do, but the souls we sold.
Well, our not literal souls.
No, but the ones we collect from the dead.
But we are definitely shilling for big companies because capitalism rocks. Anyway.
I mean, there is that.
This week, Gory Storytime is brought to you by InWorld Movies, the streaming service that films and streams the TV shows and movies that are watched in TV shows and movies. We have the Stab movies from Scream, Thanksgiving by Eli Roth, from the fake commercials between the Grindhouse films Planet Terror and Death Proof. We have TV shows too, full seasons of Terrence and Phillip from South Park, The Happy Little Elves, and Itchy and Scratchy from The Simpsons, and many more. That's InWorld Movies, because we don't have enough to watch already.
Accurate. Always gonna run out of stuff to watch. And by FinalGirlsDating.com, the dating site where girls who have defeated machete-wielding maniacs and
words.
Yeah, those words. From the top. And by FinalGirlsDating.com,
the dating site. The top's up here.
Shut up. The dating site where girls who have defeated machete-wielding maniacs and psycho-zombie-like killers and now are ready for love. Final Girls Dating will even give you tips on how to deal with trauma they have been through. But let's be honest, if you aren't chasing her through the woods with a chainsaw, you already have a leg up on the last person they dealt with. That's Final Girls Dating. Take a stab at love.
All right.
That's good.
Now, let's get into the behind-the-scenes information. Is there anything else you wanted to say about the movie before that? Yeah, me either.
Yeah, I mean...
So?
Yeah. Wes Craven filmed three different endings and didn't tell the cast which one he was going to use.
He didn't tell the audience either. We still don't know. No.
It's a hell of a way to end a movie.
It's like, they're about to rip the mask off and cut to his credits. Yeah. Neve Campbell was concurrently shooting Drowning Mona and Party of Five during the production of this film. Because her Drowning Mona character had long streaked hair, she had to wear a wig to play Sydney, which required 2 hours of application each morning. Because a two-hour wig. I know.
You're doing something wrong. Patrick Dempsey was hired the day before shooting began. He had one night to learn three big dialogue-heavy scenes.
The green outfit worn by Parker Posey on set was the same one worn by Courtney Cox in Scream. All sets for Stab 3 were replicas of the originals because the original sets were destroyed after Scream wrapped.
Oh, wow. Neve Campbell's contract allowed her to be on set for just 20 days, which is why Sydney had less screen time than her in the other films. As a result of her role being reduced, more emphasis was put on the supporting characters.
Yes.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah. The house used during the climax, where most of the killing takes place, is the same house used as a school in Halloween H2O 20 years later.
Yeah.
Which is weird that they would use it for a house and for a school, because house rooms and school rooms don't usually look similar.
Not even a little, actually. Other than being rooms.
I mean...
Carrie Fisher helped rewrite some of her lines.
Yeah, which is why I thought it was weird that she said, "Help me, Obi-Wan, there's a guy with a knife."
There's a guy with a knife.
David Arquette and Courtney Cox met on the set of Scream, dated while shooting Scream 2, and were married a month before principal photography of this movie began. They cut short their honeymoon to film it. Cox added Arquette to her name as seen in the credits.
Yes. The film never had a public test screening. The cast and crew only had their first chance to see the finished product at the premiere because of fears of spoilers being put out on the internet.
Makes sense.
So they didn't even know the ending that was chosen
until
it came out?
Yep.
That's yikes.
Jamie Kennedy, despite appearing in each of the first three films, has never appeared in any of the movie posters.
All right. It's messed up.
But people were like cheering in the theater when he showed up after being dead in two and showed up in three.
Oh, yeah.
Spoiler alert, since the fact literally said he was in this movie.
Right. Scott Foley's feature film debut.
Jimmy Lee Curtis was offered the role of Bianca Burnett, but turned it down because she said, why would I do a horror movie?
Yeah, that's probably why. The song Red Right Hand is played in the first three movies of the franchise.
Did you know they even had a song about that time of the month and being at one with yourself?
Now is the time to cut to that camera he hates.
Shut up. The publicity stills of young Maureen Prescott and Rena Reynolds are actually early modeling photos of a young Lynn McRae, the actress who played adult Maureen Prescott. So they were, that's why it looked like her, because it was her.
That's great. A big twist was planned for the killings to be caused by insane fans of the Stab movies. The twist would come where Sydney, Nev Campbell, visited a house where all the teenagers had been killed, only for the bodies to get up and reveal themselves as the killers.
Which was used in Saw.
But that would have been... not really.
Have you seen Saw, where the killer was the dead guy the whole time and he got up and revealed himself to be the killer? Literally said the same thing.
Yeah, but
literally said the same thing.
That's a bunch of killers. That's dumb.
But dead bodies getting up and being like, I'm the one who is killing, happened in Saw.
Yeah, whatever.
Holy crap. Throughout this movie, the actresses and actors from Stab 3, the movie within the movie, complain about the rewrites in three different scripts. Those complaints were actually from the real cast of the movie because of their frequent rewrites in three different endings.
Hmm. Courtney Cox remarked about her relationship and with then-husband David Arquette in relation to the Scream franchise. I was just flirting with David on the first one. I was sleeping with him in the second one, and we shared a trailer in the third.
Roman Bridger, played by Scott Foley, the director of the movie within the movie, complains he had to make a horror film before he could make a classic love story. Something similar happened to Wes Craven himself. He had to agree to do this movie before he was allowed to make the musical drama Music of the Heart, which I didn't even know.
What?
Yeah, I know.
I certainly don't think of that when I watch this. Large amounts of footage were filmed due to the script constantly changing. Randy's video message, a 3-minute scene, had over 2 hours of footage filmed for it.
Mm-hmm. Kate Hudson was cast, but replaced prior to the commencement of principal photography. This movie is listed in her credits on the back cover of the VHS box for the movie Desert Blue. The role in which Hudson was cast is unknown, but speculation is it was Christine or Sarah, who had, whatever.
All right. And in relation to the last fact I read about the Randy's video message,
mm-hmm.
the rules for a horror film trilogy stated in this movie are, 1, the killer must be superhuman. Mere stabbing or shooting will not be enough to kill the killer. 2, anyone can die, including the main character. 3, the past will come back to haunt someone. Detective Mark Kincaid warns, all I know about movie trilogies is in the third one, all bets are off.
Yes, which was used in the trailer, so see? All right.
Threw that away.
Okay. The people on Rotten Tomatoes have it at 37%. Liked this film.
Yeah, and the critics had it at a whopping 39% liked this film.
Now, that doesn't mean it's 37% of a good movie, meaning a third of it was all right, basically.
Right.
It actually means a third of the people, a little over a third,
it,
liked it.
Gave it a good review.
I think we should talk about our favorite and least favorite scenes. What do you want to do first?
We can do least favorite.
All right. My least favorite thing, honestly, as much as it was cool to see Jamie Kennedy's character, they just wedged that in.
I mean, yeah.
There was no reason to invent the character of the sister who's like, hey, just in case, like, in case murders happen and I die, I've taped this saying what a trilogy is. It's like, eh, stop it. Like,
right. I mean,
people literally cheered when they first saw him. They're like, oh my God.
Scene.
And it's like,
I love that scene. That's a great character.
It was wedged in so, like, ham-fistedly that, I'm sorry, I just, it doesn't, it
I
kills,
mean, if they had actually planned on the staying a trilogy,
it kills the momentum.
It's perfect to have him in it.
Except he was dead, and there's no reason that he would have said, because then there would be another videotape where, what if I die in the first one, and I gotta get him ready for the second one, and no.
Yeah.
No.
He seems like the guy that would have done that.
And he didn't, though,
I mean,
so
he
it
did.
Just, I mean, he
did
for
not
the third
watch
one. Yeah, no.
Because he did it.
It's so dumb.
How do you know he didn't just scrap the
it's
other two?
Dumb.
I mean, yeah, it was. But I like that
What's
scene.
Your least favorite
My
scene?
My least favorite scene is a confusion I had the entire time. So it's not really the movie's fault. But I swear that the first time I watched this movie, Cotton Weary was the killer.
Okay, you can't fault the movie for you're an idiot.
Okay, well.
So what's your least favorite thing that was actually a thing that you can blame the movie for?
All right, the killer wasn't actually, like, related to Sydney. Really.
I mean,
like,
it literally
like,
was exactly
was,
the
Not really. Like, it was.
If you haven't seen this, spoiler alert, it's her brother, retard.
No, it's really kind of not, though.
I mean, it is. Like
why
her
didn't
mom
he come
had
up
a baby. Oh, why did the kid that she had out of wedlock from a, like, giant raping that she gave up for adoption, why didn't she tell her daughter that when she was a kid? Hey, just so you know, mommy was violently raped repeatedly by a group of people in Hollywood. I had a kid and gave it up because I couldn't handle it. That's a conversation she would have randomly?
With her child, yeah.
No.
I mean, it's Hollywood.
I hate the realism of this film.
Yeah.
Why didn't she have an unrealistic conversation with her child at
it's
five?
Very nitpicky. I like this movie. I like all of them, so stop.
You're so dumb.
Yeah, so what's your favorite scene?
My favorite scene? Boy, you know, honestly, I'm gonna go with... There's a few that I'm, like, debating between, so I'm trying to figure out which one to choose.
Cause... Well, I have one. And
all right, you do yours. And...
So, I'm actually surprised that it wasn't this for you.
It might be one of my contenders.
Well, Jay and Silent Bob.
Yeah.
I absolutely love that they are in this movie
As those characters.
I love that. I absolutely love it, because...
That makes it this Viewisk universe and the Scream films in the same universe.
Which means I
Except,
can have reason to
like
watch
I pointed
all of
out,
those movies.
In the Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back film, they walked onto the set of Scream 4, where a monkey was the killer.
Yeah.
So it's in the same world, but in their world, Stab and Scream are both series of films.
So, like, here's the real thing.
It's weird.
Did Jay and Silent Bob, real life Jay and Silent Bob, get told, hey, since you walked onto the set of 3 and were in 3, walk onto the set of 4 too?
Yeah, except it was Scream 4, it was Stab 3. Yeah.
No, in the movie Scream 3, I'm saying,
right, but
were Jay and Silent Bob hired to be in Scream 3 because of them being... Yeah, okay.
Anyway, this is a series of movies that has Ben Affleck play 3 people, and one's in...
4 people,
four
including
people.
Himself.
Yeah, he plays himself, and he plays an angel, for gosh sakes. So, whatever. Like, that universe is effed. But,
yes.
All right, so I'm going to say my favorite scene. I'm going to go with one of the kills, or attempted kills. was when Dewey, because somehow it was the third time Dewey should be dead and wasn't.
Oh, yeah. He's good at that.
But even more than him almost dying was when he was shooting at the killer. That's what I'm actually going
with. Oh, yeah?
Because he kept shooting him in the chest, and finally Sydney was like, in the head. He's wearing a vest. Shoot him in the head. So he did, and oh, look, he wasn't dead. Superhuman anymore because it was made to be realistic, and shot right here kept him down.
It did. I remember that.
So I liked that they tried to make it realistic. It's like when the guy got back up, it's like, how? Oh, bulletproof vest.
They kept showing bulletproof vests, so it was like, all right.
Yeah.
I expected that.
Yeah, absolutely. So that's what I'm going with.
All right, yeah.
On a scale of 1 to 10.
I'm going to go with an 8.
8?
8.
See, I'm going to go with like a 6.5 because the first two were both better. They were.
Yeah.
They just were.
They were.
It was good.
Well, and oddly, I think the fourth one is better than this one.
The fourth one...
I really liked that one.
I think they stretched it too much. Maybe we'll do that at some point, but not right now.
We'll do 3/4 next time.
4/4.
No, 3/4.
4/4.
To, you know.
Yeah, but we do 4 of a thing.
Not anymore. There's 3 weeks in a month now.
Anyway.
So, yeah. Anything else to say about the movie?
Not really. So, what do you do?
Over there.
There should be some information coming up on the screen.
No, because that's this is the wide shot.
Oh, shit. Look at that.
Oh, hi, Dad. Okay. So, you can you can watch this show on Fact TV, channel 1076, Thursdays at 8:30 p.m. and Fridays at 7 p.m.
You can like us on Facebook, and by us, I mean Corey Storytime and Fact TV.
You can go to fact8.com.
You'll see old episodes of this show and many other shows.
And everything they have.
You can check us out on Twitter. I'm Jason T. Jake 17. Just kidding. That's this dumbass.
Yeah, I'm Jason Jakes. I'm at Jason T. Jake 17, capital J, capital G, capital J.
I'm actually at Craig Jakes, all lowercase, all one word. We don't really talk about this show, but nope, whatever.
Not at all. If you want to get offended, come on out.
And then there's also one called...
Nope, that's for the other show.
I know, but you can still bring it up. You want to just hear random messed up things that have come out of my mouth?
It's at Jiggly Firm Brain.
Capital J.
Brain.
Okay.
Capital J, capital F, capital B.
And it's just crazy stuff that has come out of my mouth in random conversations that he tweets out of context. Anyway.
Yes.
That's it for this week.
Until next time, I'm your host, Jason.
I'm his co-host and his father, Craig.
And sweet dreams.